Well, so social media have played an important role in many recent protests around the world. The Arab Spring, the Occupy movement, the Spanish Indignados, the Umbrella Revolution in Hong Kong. So even though all these movements responded to very different social contexts and they emerged in very different circumstances, they all share one common thread, which is that they all use social media in order to promote their message, in order to increase awareness of their cause. At the same time, social media users are often dismissed as slacktivists, which is this term that some commentators coin to highlight the fact that when you like some information or you retweet some content, you are not really committed to a political cause. That's not real and genuine political engagement. And so in this research, we decided to figure out what's the actual role that these slacktivists play in the growth of social protests. And in particular, we were interested in answering one question. Do these low commitment participants really help raise awareness of a political cause, or do they simply engage in feel-good politics? So to answer this question, we looked at millions of tweets sent around different political protests. One of those protests were the protests that emerged in May 2013 in Gezi Park in Turkey. And in that case, we had more than 30 million tweets sent by about 3 million users. We also located some of those users, so we were able to separate out how many of them were actually on the streets where the action was taking place. And so what we found is that communication dynamics around political protests have a very special structural signature. So you have a core of highly committed participants. So that would be the users on the streets. But then to spread the word out, you also need the large periphery of low commitment participants who might only retweet one message every now and then, but who on the aggregate generate as much information as the core of very active users. What this study shows is that we should be paying more attention to the periphery of networks. If you want an idea to go viral, or if you want a protest or a social movement to grow, you need a core of highly committed participants, but you also need a periphery echoing that information, because in the end, you don't have leaders if you don't have followers.